The Bucks have lost three straight. This is the first time all season that's happened. Do you still believe in them?
I do, but my belief is waning, right? And it's really when you look at the way their team is playing, I feel like now that they see how they're guarding Giannis, right, they're just taking away Giannis. So now the pressure becomes on the shooters, right? You got to knock down shots, and you're going to have to continue knocking down shots. And for me, they just haven't done it. I believe that Milwaukee is going to win because I thought that their bench was far better. But when you have Van Fleet hitting six threes, when you have Kyle Lowry playing the way he's been playing, and just their entire bench, Marcus Gasol. So when they play that way, it's tough.
Well, this is my take on the Bucks. And I picked Toronto to win this series simply on experience. Yep. And it's showing right now. I think, you know, with how Kawhi is playing right now, finals MVP experience, Danny Green championship experience, Marc Gasol and Serge Ibaka multiple playoff games played.
And I thought Kyle Lowry's been in big games before.
Yeah, no, for sure, right. And I think when you go this deep in the playoffs, it's not about schemes and X's and O's no more. Mm-hmm. It's about willpower. And I think experience is taking over, and guys know everybody's tendencies now. So at the end of the day, you watching this, and it's not surprising that they're taking this away from Giannis. Yeah. And I don't believe in the Bucks right now. I think it's over with.
Yeah.
I think Toronto has snatched their soul. Kawhi got Giannis in a straitjacket, and he's out playing them on both ends. I mean, what we're watching right now in Kawhi Leonard is probably arguably the best two-way player we've seen since Scottie Pippen.
Well, first of all, that's a huge statement and certainly high praise. Producer Steve, I want to know if we can get the bar at the bottom that says Kendrick, colon, Toronto has snatched their soul. Because I would just like to see that on TV on The Jump. I mean, look, the Raptors do, as Drake pointed out, they're one win away from their first NBA Finals appearance.
You got to be careful with that, Drake.
What do you guys think of that?
I think that our very own T-Mac, right, the Jump's own T-Mac, he might have said something similar on the podium and said it's going to be so good to get to the second round. I think they were up 3-1 against Detroit, and that didn't work out. So, look, you know, and he's a fan, but you have to understand that you're more than a fan. Like, you are an actual basic ambassador for the Toronto Raptors.
Yeah.
Like, so for you to come out and say this, even though the players might back off of this, you are still basically a part of the Raptors organization saying this. So that could be motivation.
And I agree. And then what Drake is doing, he's putting a lot of pressure on the players.
Yeah.
I mean, they already have pressure to close it out. But for you to come out and make that statement, that's bold. That's almost guaranteeing a win for tomorrow night. And you can't count Milwaukee out, but I think who still snatched their soul.
Boom.
There you go.
That's what I wanted. Thank you, Producer Steve. Do you think, though, the Raptors, something has changed for them over the last three games, that they're on, that they figured something out?
Well, I think they've settled into their defense. I think those first two games, and that's part of the finals and part of postseason, is like what your defense is game one or game two, it's going to be something very, very different, unless you sweep a team. If you sweep a team, we've got what we're doing, and it's going to keep working. But if you're playing against quality opponents, they're going to be able to adjust and play different ways. And right now, like Siakam, just the way he's just dominated and played well, and all of a sudden Brook Lopez, who was great last series, it hasn't really played the same way. So it just becomes tough when you look at the Raptors and the way they play defense, and then Milwaukee not being able to answer that wall and knocking down shots.
And well, I see two things. One is that the thing that changes is that obviously you put Kawhi on Giannis. Okay, we take that, but I think even in this playoff season, Toronto has been battle tested, meaning they went seven games with Philly, where more so Milwaukee had a cakewalk. So now when things are starting to get tight, Toronto is like, we've been here before.
Well, that reminds me of you guys in 2008. When you won the title with Boston in 2008, you went as far in every playoff series as you could possibly go. You took every single series to its max. And when we were going into the finals, a lot of people said, oh,
they're tired.
They're going to be tired. The Lakers are going to be more fresh. And you guys kept saying, no, that's because we know how to play when it gets down to
it. Absolutely. And once again, it goes back to experience. And I think, you know, you got to give a lot of credit to Nick Nurse, too, also, because for the simple fact that he stuck with Van Vliet. Mm-hmm. Van Vliet has been horrible throughout these playoffs.
Oh,
and then he has come on strong. And I also got to give a lot of credit to Norman Powell, because he didn't really play that much this season or last series. He stayed professional. He stayed game ready. And he's been coming in off the bench, and he's been producing at a high level for the Raptors. And he's been really key for them.
And that's so important. And it's hard to do, by the way. Guys kind of start to check out mentally.
He hasn't done that. Locked in.
And look, we don't know if Van Vliet is going to stay as hot as he did in these last two games.
Well, it's like Brooke Lopez.
I don't know. Maybe he can have another baby before the next game.
Wow. Hopefully not. Don't double up.
I'm just saying.
Don't go Rogers Cromartie on us. He said that's the key to playing loose,
is that he's more just doesn't care about other stuff now because he cares about his kid.